Well, hey folks, my name's Mike and I've been doing these resin epoxy stuff for a while. Some people, friends of mine said, hey, you gotta make a video about it. So I've decided why not. So what I'm doing here, mixing up my epoxy. I'm just gonna mix. I'm only doing about 6 ounces because I'm only doing 3 petri dishes. I put just a tad bit shy of 2 ounces in each one. My room's been 75, 76 degrees for a while. I keep the studio warm so the epoxy will cure. If it's below 74, it'll never really cure. It'll be too pliable and it'll bend. Found that out the hard way. Anyway, yeah, been doing epoxy stuff for a while. Been building river tables, stuff like that. Working with life slabs, large slab stuff. It's a lot of fun. But one of my things is I usually do this to music because I like music. So anyway, almost done mixing this. Pretty clear. Still got a lot of bubbles in it. Anyway, so I am going to go ahead and start some jams. I don't know. This is my first time, so hopefully I get the volume levels right where I can still bore you with my little narrative and can still have some fun jamming. But tonight it's Volbeat, a great band from Europe. So anyway, let's have some fun. So anyway, like I said, I got 2 ounces. I'm gonna put about 2 ounces in each one of these cups. Here we go. You're encouraged to stand up and move around a little bit. Pressure off the spine, that's fun. I'm jamming, you can't see it. People who know me will tell you you're lucky. Very, very, very good friend of mine told me one time that my dancing reminded him of a octopus falling out of a very tall tree. I dig it. All right, put my cup up. A couple seconds for the bubbles to have some fun. This little creme brulee burner I picked up. You get up at any kitchen store. Works a lot bigger than the big old blue propane bottles. A lot more forgiving. A lot easier to mess around with. Alright, so I'm going to do some yellows. I'm gonna do some blues and we'll do some reds. I'm trying to do flowers in each one, but you never can tell what this epoxy is gonna do. But it cures and likes to move around. I love the tunes. Much energy. Alright, we'll do some yellow. Try to make this a flower. Yellow petals. Orange. Yellow on the outside. just want to drop it in really gently. Don't want anybody to say I was too rough with my... just kidding, playing. I do want to drop the wide in real gently though. Wide is very heavy. And I'm trying to avoid the spots on the back side. Some people like them. I'm more of a, nah, not so much type of guy. Nice orange for the center. Three drops. Whoa! Stop that. Cap for my white got in the middle there, and it might. Alright, oh dang it. I'm losing about that. How about this? First time I've ever had it be doing that. Alright. Different yellow? Raise your hands up to the wall. Come on, baby. There we go. That happens. Okay, well, let's see if we can see them work.
The devil's burning cross.
Alright, what do you think? Yellow? More yellow around the outside in the area? No, I think orange in the middle. Three drops. All right, let's see what that does. Let's play some blue. Get all my yellows out of the way. Pardon my hairy arms. All right. Oops, not like this. Go away. Go away. Thank you. Thank you very much. Your turn. Go away. All right.
This one will be a little different. There we go. Down, down, down.
Come on, buddy, you can drop.
You can do it, there you go.
Proud of you. Just trying to do a very gentle drop, that's why.
This should be white.
Fallen kids. Raise your hands, what do you hold? Y'all love the way this ink melds and rolls. Freaking awesome, man.
Hey,
I gotta turn this up, guys.
Yes.
Ah!
Don't freak out. That's right.
I am a trained professional and other things besides this stuff. Yes, I'm dropping some black on. Yeah, man. I love them. That black is so deep. Crazy Ed's Furniture, I'm going out of my mind. Oh yeah, we're gonna layer this. When I was young, I had this piece of glass rock. The longest time I thought it was marble. But I found out it was a piece of glass cast off. But it was orange and yellow and red and had the veins going through. It had that little thing of black in there, which, okay, yeah, it's rock. But it was amazing. I love the colors. And the way they had the vein, and the veins are very sharp and clear. Side of that. What do I need on the outside? It's for volume, guys. Alright. Look how the colors pick that out. That is wild. This stuff, really works. For me, I find myself attracted to it because of my ADHD. At the age of 51, I was diagnosed. ADHD, primarily hyperactive. What are the odds, everybody who knew me said. Ruined 3 marriages. Not proud of it. I learned a lot. One of the things is I've learned that I was denying myself this type of stimulation that I need, thinking, oh, that's not manly. Yeah, right. Go away. I think it's very manly. I love this shit. Still, pardon me. All right. Do I go yellow in that gold and that purple? Oh, that looks really cool. Let's try it. Maybe that or go another purple, but I think we need that contrast. Some bright yellow, cadmium yellow. When in doubt, go nuclear.
Radioactive.
Just say go to the or go home.
I don't want to go home, but I am home.
I know. That's talking like more epoxy dripping.
Alright.
Two drops of purple.
A really, really, really wild orange now.
We got Calabasa and Sunset.
Let's go Calabasa.
Yeah, I'm going to go too.
Two drops, Calabasa. I said Calabasa, baby.
Oh, whoa, hold on.
Kill boy.
Like I said before, I'll be glad you can't see the dancing. We call them fish and wildlife.
Center track, I don't remember that at all. That's starting to build really cool too.
Sometimes it's hit or miss on how this stuff develops.
So I want to hit the purple.
Yeah, I know. I'm going way beyond where a person should go. I'm loving every second. I'm trying new things, right?
Really good.
I mean, everybody always says, you know, turn it over, that's a really nice sign, it's a finish sign.
Oh. One of my favorite songs from the guys. But everybody always says, you know, hey, turn it over, you know, the finish side, the bottom, that's, you know, with the rounded edges and it's all pretty and everything. 95% of the time I prefer this side. This side's always got the really cool symmetrical design, like this one's got the flower, or sunburst, if you will. I think that's really cool. This kind of looks like a bowling ball, in a way.
I don't know. Aquatic, I guess.
Oh, that's pretty cool, though. This one, oh boy. I love that purple. It's just, it's all the colors. It's like what's going on in my head 24 hours a day. I love that one. That's going to work. If it's even close to this one, it's done. You know what? I've got one. Two. Three. Very interesting. I've got three 8-inch silicone molds here. Alright, well, I'm gonna cover this up. And I think I'm gonna switch everything around. I hope y'all don't mind. I'm gonna start doing this because I'm liking it. I live alone. This is kind of fun. Makes me feel like I'm talking to somebody. Ho 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 ho. But alright. I will post how these look, or I will add on to this when I pull these tomorrow night. But I'm really hoping this one works. That is just like amazing. Let's see if I can get it real close for y'all. Alright, look at that. Oh crap, sorry. Alright. My camera's sitting on a tripod, obviously. I'm trying to make people feel seasick, sorry. And the green one. Alright, let me go up a little close. Take your seasick pills. Oh, come on and focus. Yeah, it's not going to focus. I think that's cool. I dig the colors. That's what I'm loving. All right, let's try this last one. I end up breaking my darn tripod. All right. That's a little sunburst there. Get up close on it. Maybe it'll focus in on this one. It's trying. That's cool. Sorry. Anyway, I think it's in. Oh. But yeah, that's all the inks and everything. Whoa, hold on. All right, let's take a look around here. That's my table. Right now, I use that for epoxy painting, paints, doing my coasters and my plaques, wall mounts. Over there, I just got finished doing some a table, epoxy in the middle. It's real cool. It'd be nice. Let's see. That's a work table over there, supplies, yada, yada, yada. Those are my chairs. I'm going to have them for displays once I start actually selling this stuff. That's a barn door I built to block the studio off from the rest of the house. Had fun with that. It's cool. But anyway. So, I'm going to go ahead and tell you goodnight on this one. Leave you with this. Which way? There we go. But I'll pop them out tomorrow. Attach the end of this. And hopefully it'll be cool. Alright, later gators. Well, alright, how y'all doing? It's the next day. Actually, next day and a half for one of them. Get this out of the way. I did a painting in the interim. That's a pretty cool spillover. Got to figure out what to do with all this stuff. It's piling up. But anyway, let's get down to what we're here for. All right, first things first. Do the petri. So I did the three petris. Hey, how about I turn some light on? Look at that. Now we can see, huh? Check the camera. Well, you can see kind of. I'm not Francis Ford Coppola, as you can tell. Anyway, did some purple, some blue, and some yellow. Actually, this was a purple, reddish, orangish. Anyway. So I did these three, so I think it's time to pull them out. Haven't pulled them out yet. Alright. Bring it a little closer. Pardon me, take your Dramamine. Okay, let's move it in a little bit. There we go. Still mess with the camera, let's do that. Alright. A little closer. Alright, this is the purple one. It's the side that was up in the mold. Really like that. That's the back. Back looks pretty cool. I really wish I could figure out a way to keep the white from clumping, from dropping all the way through. Something I gotta figure out. Anyway, that's the purple. See, there we go. It's purple, front, back. Okay, I got this pretty blue and green. Pop that out. All right, there we go. That's the front, or the top side in the mold. Kind of see through the sides here, around here. That's the back side. Man, I love the way the color is integrated and layered. I wish I could get rid of that those clumps of white. I shake it up real good. That's what they said. They say, shake it up. I shake it up. The cars would be proud of me. I shake it up. But without that, this would be amazing on this side. I don't know. It's like I can't see the forest through the trees. I can't see the... Can't see past this. It catches my eye too much. Alright, now we get this orange one. I know, every time I do an orange, it turns out like this. Kind of like a... Oh, flower. There we go. Sorry. That's the side that was up. And that's the back. Once again... I didn't get so many of the white, but still, I mean, that would be amazing without all those clumps. Gotta figure out how to do that. No, I think it's cool. That side is just, it's so sharp and clear. A little sunburst in the middle. Really like that. Alright, those are those three I was playing with. Oh, but look, I did more. Okay, where are we at? There we are. Move it there. Okay, did this one. Got three rounds and a square. Square's kind of funny. Got three rounds. This one, I didn't know what I was doing. I did greens on the outside and I did a... I don't know, I was messing around, I was having fun. Okay? Alright. Anyway. That's what it looks like in the mold. Alright, time to pull it. Ooh. This is gonna be sweet. Alright. So, here we go. This is what it looks like. Man, without that orange on there, that translucent, seeing through, that is wild. That's beautiful. I don't even want to look at the back. The back's going to have to be totally amazing. Okay. Oh. And it is. Oh, that's sweet. That is sweet. Never worry, I'll go through these a little closer. I'll throw something white down behind it. We good? Alright, got another one coming up. Oh man, that's amazing. Alright. I love this stuff. I'll get 4 hours of sleep tonight, so I'll be playing with this stuff. Busting butt at work all day tomorrow. Come home. Do this about 12 o'clock, be up at 4:30. It's awesome. I'm energized. All right, opening another one. This is the other orange one I did a couple of nights ago. I need to get more of these molds. This orange one. Okay, can we see? Oh, look there. Maybe. Same color palette. This has got a bit more red. Anyway, once again, when you can see through it, you can see how sharp it is. Am I getting it without the glare? I hope so. Like I said, after this show and tell, I'll put them all down. Ooh, red kind of got a star. Maybe too much white? Is it the fact that I'm using too much? I don't know. Alright. Next. This one, one of my favorite color combinations is the purple and the gold and the yellow. It looks electric. Or like a lava flow. For all you other Lord of the Rings geeks. The lava flows of Mordor. But yeah, this one, God, this just turned out amazing. Can you see it? Yes, you can. Okay, cool. Yeah, I know, I'm horrible with the camera. There we go. But it's amazing how clear they are. How clear this gold, this vein of gold and orange and yellow going through the middle. It'd be funny if this is just all fuzzy. Oh, you had manual focus, not autofocus on. Okay, backside. Not so much something to write home about on this one. Get rid of the white globs. It's a whole other story. But those globs really just, it draws the attention away from the layered color underneath. I don't know. I gotta figure that out. Did I say I gotta figure that out? I think I gotta figure that out. Alright. Texted my ex-wife a couple nights ago and said, give me three colors. Give me a three color combination. No matter what. She said, navy blue, light gray, and teal. Interesting. So, I did some navy blue. Or mixed up what I thought looked like navy blue. Did a green that I kind of thinned out a little bit, I guess. Then I tried to make a light gray. Hence emphasis on the word try. It worked out actually pretty good. I did a little black and a little white. But this is her color combination. At first, when I got done pouring it, about an hour after I poured it, all this was like out to here. And it was very clear and very grand, very veiny and everything. And it was just amazing. It was gorgeous. But, as you know, as epoxy cures, it moves. And all this kind of collapsed in on itself. It's still sharp. Goodness, it is still very sharp. It's just not... It's just smaller than it was, I guess. Smaller. Molds are coming apart. I need to order some more molds. And backside. Oh, nice. I swirled this one. Because what I did on the front, which is weird, is I poured the three colors. with white, of course. And she said it looked like eyeballs, so it's kind of freaky. So I said, yeah, those look like eyeballs. So I swirled it. I just did back and forth and up and down. And that's what it did to the front. You can see the swirl lines here. Very cool. I like this. I wish that glob wasn't there. That'd be a really cool feature. But yeah, that's what I did. Alright, let me find something white. I'll put all these on there real quick and we'll do a little. I'll get the camera down. Alright. People say, Mike, you're not ready. I said, look at there. Alright, so let's go a couple at a time so as not to bore everybody for very long. Alright, let me pull you down. Once again, hold on. It's the camera, not your house. Earthquake! Alright, turn this thing. Oops, there we go. Alright, here we go. This is the purple one. I really like this color combination. I like the way it looks like fire going down the middle. Almost like electric fire. It's very cool. Getting a little purple one. Just got in the middle, pardon me. Not as much see-through, not as much translucent. Get my lights closer. This is something that needs a good light. Alright, here we go. Yeah, it's purple. We got that blue one I did. The blue and the green. God. I really need to learn how to work a camera, don't I? It's got some really fine detail stuff in there, too. And then the blue one. Oops. Light bulb. Or as Gru would say, light bulb. All right. I'm going to look at this one while I flip these other ones over. That way you don't watch me flip. It's like magic. Oh my gosh, they were just the other way. How did that happen? All right. Back of the green one. Not my favorite. There's those white blobs. Excuse me. Back to the purple one. Back to the little purple one. Once again, those white blobs, if they weren't there, without them, everything's super dark. Alright, and blue, teal, and light gray. And it's got some cool swirls in there, but alright, so let me pull another one over. Oh, what's that sitting on the horizon? It's saying, hey, look at me, look at me. What could that possibly be? I know, this is goofy. I don't want dead air, right? Alright, bring that bad boy on over. Okay. This is that orange one. It's got some fire in it. That red in the middle is really bright. Really bold. I don't even know if this thing will focus that close. Looks like a, I don't know. You tell me what it looks like. Okay, and then there's a small orange one. All that's fire in the middle. Let's scoot this over a little bit. There we go. Big orange one, back side. It's got a little star. I mean, if you think about it, the little white blobs can look like clouds. Really, really well defined edged clouds. All right, I'll flip over the orange one. Oops. Orange one's got some smuck on it. All right. That's the orange one. Almost looks like a, like an orange cross section. That's actually pretty cool. All right, I think my favorite out of these, besides that other purple one, this one. Scoot it over, see what I got. All right, this one. This one's something special. I really like that. That center spot is just gorgeous. See what the other side looks like. What do you say? That's pretty cool. Not a thing wrong with that. I like the other side better, but this one I didn't have a whole bunch of white blobs. It's the blobs. God, I can't get away from that glare. Sorry. All right. Flip that over. You all have a wonderful night. Time to go call my kiddo and tell her to sleep well. Later.